Hello everyone, let's get started. So welcome to another lecture as part of our ME6151 computational heat and fluid flow course. So in the last lecture we looked at a couple of versions of simple algorithm, that is simple revised and simple corrected, right? And thereafter we kind of saw how to extend the staggered grid to basically to curvilinear meshes or to unstructured meshes, and we realized that it was not very easy, although there were several fixes that are available in the literature, but it was not very straightforward to do an extension of a staggered grid approach for unstructured meshes, or for that matter even curvilinear meshes. Okay, so as a result we decided that the best solution to move forward was basically to get back or revert back to the co-located approach, where essentially you store the velocities as well as the pressures at the cell centroids. Okay, now however we know that if you switch back to a co-located approach, then this pressure velocity checkerboarding would come into play, and that is where we saw how the equations support checkerboarding in the context of co-located storage, right? So that's what we saw in the last class. So one of the fixes for this to avoid pressure velocity checkerboarding is basically to do something known as momentum interpolation or Re-Chow interpolation. This was suggested by Re and Chow in about early 1980s. So that is what we are going to see today. Okay, so basically the idea is if you have let's say if you have a momentum equation for U east and a momentum equation for UP, then the phase value, assuming you have a two-dimensional uniform mesh, then the phase value U east can be written as a linear average or arithmetic average of U capital E and U capital P upon 2. So this can also be written as, in terms of hat velocities, as UE hat plus UP hat by 2. Remember, UE hat basically has sigma n b u n b plus b upon the coefficient that is coming from U east or UP, right? Essentially for A east will be there for UE hat, and in the denominator AP will be there in the definition of UP hat. Okay, so we already saw this expression in the last class. Essentially the phase velocity using a arithmetic average is either UE plus UP by 2, or in terms of the right hand side values it will be UE hat plus UP hat by 2, plus you have this extra pressure terms, that is DP by 4 times PW minus P east plus D east by 4 times PP minus P east east, right? Essentially each of these terms come from each of the pressure gradients coming in the equation for UP and in the equation for U east, right? I think we realize that. Now the idea is essentially what Re-Chow interpolation or momentum interpolation suggests is that because this particular pressure term is only dependent on the non-contiguous pressures, that means it is dependent on P west and P east, right, which are not contiguous because there is PP in between which is not taken into account. And similarly, the other pressure difference PP and P east east is also non-contiguous, or it's kind of alternate cell values, not the adjacent cell values, because in between you have P east which is not taken into consideration. Okay, as a result, what momentum interpolation suggests is you replace this pressure terms with something that is contiguous. Okay, that means you replace these two terms with d little e times pp minus p east. Okay, that means your final equation in terms of hat velocities would be ue hat plus up hat by 2, plus this entire thing is replaced with d little e times pp minus p east. Now of course you see that this is basically a difference in pressure for adjacent cell values, okay, unlike this difference in pressure which are for non-adjacent cell values, right, for non-contiguous cell values, whereas this one is now for the adjacent cell values. Of course one consequence we see right away is that because of this fix, we what we say is basically we don't have we don't have this pressure checkerboarding anymore, because now instead of P west and P east you have a dependency on PP and P east. As a result, the pressure checkerboarding would be gone. Okay, so let us see in terms of the U east and UP. Okay, instead of this UE hat and UP UP hat, that means what we have is basically If you look at this equation, so we have just replaced something with something else. That means if I consider this equation again, so what I have is I have ue plus up by 2, that is on the left hand side, and on the right hand side what I have is ue hat plus up hat by 2 plus dp by 4 p west minus p east plus d east by 4 pp minus p east east, right? This is what we have. That means the momentum interpolation says that you replace this guy with something else. So that means what we are doing is basically we are subtracting this alternate pressure terms and we are adding an addition pressure term. Okay, that means on the both sides, if I subtract these two terms, that is basically dp by 4 p west minus p east and d east by 4 pp minus p east east, subtract it on both sides, then this guy goes to zero, right? This guy won't be there. Right, essentially this entire term would go away and then you end up with a minus of these two on the left hand side and you add plus dEPP minus P east on both sides. Okay, so essentially you subtract or you add this minus quantity and you add this plus quantity on both sides. Okay, then what we end up is basically on the left hand side you will get U east plus UP by 2 minus dP by 4, right, p west minus p east minus d east by 4 pp minus p east east, plus you get d east times pp minus p east, and on the right hand side you would basically get u east hat plus up hat by 2 plus this guy gets cancelled with this minus quantity, then what you end up with plus de pp minus p east. Okay, now essentially these are both terms are again now equal to what we have as the modified velocity for u east. Okay, so now what we see is that if it were just u east plus up by 2, then this is called as a linear interpolation, right? Then this is a linear interpolation. But what we have done is, if it is just u east plus up by 2 minus dp of this guy minus d east of this guy, then this entire thing would be your u little east, right? Essentially, if you go back here, so essentially u east plus up by 2 would be linear interpolation. Okay, now instead of linear interpolation, we have essentially two more terms that are coming into play, that is minus of this guy, minus of this d east by 4 pp minus p east east, and then we have plus d east times pp minus p east. Okay, so this is basically your adjacent pressure term. Now these two terms together make this, convert this linear interpolation into something known as momentum interpolation. Okay, so now these three terms together is basically momentum interpolation. Okay, now that is if you talk in terms of u east and up. Okay, now if you talk in terms of u east hat and up hat terms, then your u east little east is basically u east hat plus up hat by 2 plus d times pp minus p east. Okay, so this is the expression for momentum interpolation, and we have two expressions here. One is this guy, the other one is this one. The first one here is in terms of east and west, east and p, and the second one here is in terms of hat velocities for east and p. Okay, so both are one and the same, but we will be most of the times using this hat velocity based definition. So this is momentum interpolation in terms of hat velocities, and this entire thing, that is u east plus up by 2 minus dp by 4 times p west minus p east minus d east by 4 pp minus p east east plus d little e times pp minus p east is basically your momentum interpolated phase velocity, okay, in terms of east and p values. Fine, I hope this part is clear. All right, then now we know what is basically linear interpolation, what is momentum interpolation. That means if it were linear interpolation, then your u little e equals would be this value, right? U east hat plus up by 2. This is basically what we had from here, right? This is basically this value. That is nothing but u east hat plus up hat by 2 plus dp by 4 p west minus p east plus d east by 4 pp minus p east east, okay? Now, if it is momentum interpolation, then we know that u little e is basically u east hat plus up hat by 2 plus d little e times pp minus p east. Okay, now similarly for west values we can write this as linear interpolation as u little w equals uw hat plus up by 2 plus dP by 4 times P west minus P east plus dW by 4 times P west west minus PP. Okay, and the corresponding momentum interpolated reach of interpolation would be basically U west hat plus UP hat by 2 plus this non-contiguous pressure terms will be dropped and a contiguous pressure term, that is d little west times p west minus p east would be, pp would be added, right? So this is your momentum interpolated value for the west velocity, okay? That means if you look at these pressures that we have here, that means the, if we are using linear interpolation, then the terms we have are p west and p east. That means these two cells connected, shown using here using blue lines, these are non-contiguous. Similarly, PP, P east, that is PP, P east, and there is a P west, west that is coming here. So PP, P east, east, P west, west. So all these three are again non-contiguous, but if they are of the same value as that of these two, could be of a different value, then essentially this supports a pressure kind of checkerboarding, which we don't want to have. That's why we are not introducing the linear interpolation that we thought we would use before. Rather, we would work with something that is known as momentum interpolation, which has basically PP and P east, that is this term and this value in the U little e, and similarly PP west and PP, that is this cell value and this cell value, that is basically the adjacent pressure values. That is what will be used in the calculation of phase velocities in reach of interpolation, okay? So that is the difference. Now this may kind of look rather arbitrary, like why did we basically just replace something, some pressure gradient with something else, but this is actually not arbitrary. This is basically similar to what a staggered grid approach does, okay? But only thing is that here we don't have a grid that we create physically like we do in the staggered grid approach. Rather, using the interpolation, we have now created something which will depend on adjacent pressures, okay? So let us make some comments and see how does this momentum interpolated phase velocities enable us to have a non-checkerboarded solution, okay? That means the U little e and UW are functions of adjacent pressure values. Yes, that we know. Basically, it only depends on P west minus PP or P east minus PP. Okay, that is good. Then the R functions of adjacent pressure values. So that means if we use these phase velocities, that is U little e and U little w, in the continuity equation, then the continuity equation doesn't support pressure checkerboarding, which is a good news, right? Because we don't want to have pressure checkerboarding. However, if you look at the momentum equations, that those are basically again for U capital E, U capital P, U capital W, and so on. These equations still have pressure values that are similar to this, right? You will have P W minus P east into dP into delta Y by 2, right? You will have a term like that, which will still contain non-contiguous pressure values. So the momentum equations will still support checkerboarding. But that is not a problem, because if the momentum equations support checkerboarding and the continuity equation do not support checkerboarding, then we will not have this pressure velocity checkerboarding sustained towards the end of the solution, right? This will be eliminated somewhere, because both the continuity and the momentum equations have to support checkerboarding such that it will sustain, it will continue to be there, okay? So as a result, in the collocated approach, the continuity equation is now modified such that the pressure checkerboarding is avoided, whereas the momentum equations may still support checkerboarding, but we don't care about it, because in the final solution we would not have checkerboarding, because both the equations do not support it, okay? One of the equations doesn't support it, that means it will not be there, okay? Essentially, we can show that this kind of a momentum interpolation, that is basically replacing the non-contiguous pressure with some contiguous pressure difference values, results in something like an artificial diffusion, okay, which we saw before, and that is what that helps in essentially avoiding the oscillations that show up because of checkerboarding, okay, because of checkerboarding, okay. That means essentially you can show that the modified continuity equation is basically has an extra term that goes as a fourth derivative of velocities, okay? So that means you would have a fourth partial derivative of velocity. That means you will have something like partial to the power 4 u by partial to the power 4, which is more like a artificial diffusion term. And of course, even the staggered grid approach can also be shown to have this diffusion like term. Okay, essentially we are essentially achieving a staggered grid approach, but without really creating a grid and the corresponding physical values with it. Rather, we are now doing everything through some kind of an interpolation that is known as in the literature as a momentum interpolation or reach of interpolation. Okay. All right, that is good. Then now that we understand the momentum interpolation, we will now look at the how do we modify simple algorithm on collocated grids. Okay, so if you remember, we had two issues. One was the issue was there was no equation for pressure, and then there was this problem with pressure velocity checkerboarding. So the pressure velocity checkerboarding is now avoided using momentum interpolation, whereas the no equation for pressure still has to go through the simple algorithm. Okay, so now we modify our simple algorithm, or rather we apply it for a collocated grid storage. Okay, so let us consider a two-dimensional Cartesian grid. Again, let us say that the mesh is uniform for simplicity, and we are using a collocated grid. That means we are storing both the velocity components, that is u, v, as well as pressure, as well as temperature, and all the scalars. Everything is now stored at the cell centroid P. Okay, so everything is stored at the cell centroid P, and we are creating an additional velocities on the faces, which we call u little e, u little w, but they are additional set of velocities. Okay, but everything is otherwise stored at the cell centroids. Then let us look at the momentum equations. The momentum equations are basically del dot rho u bar u equals del dot mu grad u minus I dot grad p plus su. And the y component of momentum equation is del dot rho u bar v equals del dot mu grad v minus j dot grad p, that is minus partial p partial y plus sv, right? We have a source term. Now let us discretize these momentum equations at the cell centroid for cell P. Okay, so that is going to give us basically APUP equals sigma n b on b plus delta y by 2 p west minus p east plus bp. Okay, now this AP would be different from the AP that you would get for the y momentum equation, because now we are discretizing both the cells at the same cell centroid. Let us call these APs with a superscript notation, such that this will be different, of course, from the AP coming in the y momentum equation. Then let us call this all the coefficients in the x momentum equation with a superscript u, that is APU, ANBU, and BPU. Similarly, all the coefficients that you get in the y momentum equation with a superscript of v, okay, that is APV, ANBV, and BPV. Okay. So that means you have now the discrete momentum equations for cell centroid for both x and y momentum equations. Of course, what you realize is basically you see that you have pressure checkerboarding that can be supported by the momentum equations. Okay, but we will use momentum interpolation when we discretize the continuity equation, such that this pressure checkerboarding would not be supported by the continuity equation. Okay. Then what we do is let us divide with this coefficient for UP, that is let us divide with AP throughout the equation. Then we can rewrite by dividing APU and APV in the respective equations. I can write this as UP equals sigma ANBU UNB plus this guy, this is BPU upon APU, plus we have delta Y by 2 P west minus P east upon APU. Okay, so that's what we have. Then we can call this entire quantity, that is sigma NB UNB plus BP upon AP, all of them written for the U coefficients, as sum hat velocity, right? So this will be UP hat. Okay, plus again delta Y by AP, let us call it as sum DP. Okay, so that means delta Y by APU would be DPU. Then we have PW minus P east by 2 remaining as it is. So this equation, that is basically UP equals UP hat plus DPU times P west minus P east by 2, this is nothing but your basically your discrete x momentum equation, right, written in a different way, right, because essentially we just divided by AP on the right hand side, and we kind of clubbed it together, the terms for the source term and the neighboring coefficients. Okay, so this is basically your momentum equation. All right, then similarly let us write for the y momentum equation, that is AP VP equals sigma n BVNB plus delta x by 2 PS minus P naught plus BP by dividing with APV. Then what we get is VP equals sigma ANB VNB plus BP upon AP, plus you have delta x by 2 PS minus P naught by APV. Okay, and that means VP equals, we can write again this entire quantity as VP hat. Okay, this is VP hat, and then delta x by AP, let us call this as some DP. Okay, so this is DP V times PS minus P naught by 2. Okay, that means this is basically your discrete y momentum equation. Okay, so we have now the discrete x momentum and the y momentum equations. They are just written in a slightly different way. Okay. Okay. Then let us perform momentum interpolation to obtain the phase velocities. That means we already know what is u capital E and u capital P and V capital P. Similarly, we can write equations for U capital E, right? That would be U capital E would be U E hat plus D capital E hat times the corresponding values here, right? Instead of P west minus P east, you will get something in terms of basically P and P east east, like what we saw before. So then we can now write down a momentum interpolated phase value for U little E. That is U E hat plus U P by 2 plus with the adjacent pressure term, right? This is what we learned. Add the hat velocities as the arithmetic average, and then you basically add, you subtract the non-contiguous pressure and you add the contiguous pressure. That is plus D times P P minus P east, right? So we can write this as, let us write this as U E hat, U little E hat, okay? That is U E equals U E hat plus D times P P minus P east, where this D E is proposed by Rhee and Chow as to be taken as again arithmetic average of the cell coefficients for the D's. That means D U plus D P U by 2. What is D U? D U is basically your delta Y by A east for U cell, right? Similarly, D P U would be delta Y by A P for U, right? For the neighboring cells. So an average of D, those D's will give you D on the face, which we can use here. Okay, similarly, momentum interpolation can be done for each of the phase velocities. Just like what we have done for U east, we can do the same thing for U west, right? So U west would be basically U capital W hat plus UP hat by 2 plus DW times PW minus PP, right? So this can be written as well. Then essentially what we have is U little w equals, we can write this as U w hat plus a dw times p west minus pp, where again dw would be d capital w u plus dp d capital p u by 2. Okay, all right, again now we can write momentum interpolated values for v north and v south. So v north would be v north hat plus d north times pp minus p north, where V naught hat would be V capital N hat plus V P hat by 2, and D little north would be D capital N V plus D P V by 2. Okay. Similarly, V south would be V south hat plus this should be south, isn't it? This should be south. Okay, not north. So this is south times P S minus P P. So where Vs hat would be Vs hat plus Vp hat by 2, and Ds would be Ds plus Dp by 2. Okay. So what we did was basically we wrote from the cell value and its neighboring values at the cell centers, we wrote this momentum interpolated phase velocities. Okay. Remember these are not linear interpolated phase velocities. These are the momentum interpolated phase velocities, right? Because if this were linear interpolated, then you would have that alternate pressure term, which is not there. That is now removed and this is being added. Okay, so these are now the momentum interpolated phase velocities. That's what we have. That means then we have now the phase velocities on east, west, north, south, all of them. then what we do is we use these phase velocities in the solution of the continuity equation. Okay, so what we say is that if we solve the discrete momentum equations, let's say using u star, v star and p star, then the converged u star, v star field, that is for the cell centroids, for up star and vp star field, of course, even if you construct the phase velocities, will not satisfy the continuity equation. That means the flow rates that you would get, fe star, fw star, f north star and f south star, the mass flow rate continuity equation will not be satisfied for any cell, because these are basically coming from the solution of momentum equation for a guessed pressure value. Okay, so the idea is basically similar to, essentially same central idea to simple, is basically you would wish to have these flow rates be corrected, right, or the velocities be corrected such that they satisfy continuity equation. That means we want to add corrections to u little star, u w star, v north star and v south star such that f e minus f w plus f north minus f south equals 0. Okay, that means we can split each of these into a star and a prime quantities. That's what we do. And because the star quantities would be known from coming from the solution of momentum equations, they would be sent to the right hand side. Okay, so minus fe star plus fw star minus f naught star plus f south star would be there on the right hand side, which we denote as b star. Okay, and on the left hand side, these prime quantities will remain, that is fe prime minus fw prime plus f north prime minus f south prime. Okay, now of course we have these quantities that are the flow rate corrections, that is fe prime would be equal to rho u east prime delta y, and fw prime would be equal to rho u w prime delta y, f north prime would be equal to rho v north prime delta x, and f south prime would be equal to rho v south prime delta x. Now this is where the difference comes between the staggered mesh and the collocated mesh. Essentially now these u east, u w, v north, v south primes, the velocity corrections, we will get them from the momentum interpolated phase velocities. Okay, remember we just had these momentum interpolated velocities, that is u little e equals u e hat plus d e times p p minus p east, right? And a corresponding equation in terms of stars, let's say if you have a guess velocity field and a guess pressure field, there's a star missing here. So if you have a guess velocity field and a guess pressure field from which you can write the guess velocity field for the phase, u e star, as u e star equals u hat star plus d e times p p star minus p e star. Okay, so we have basically these two equations. I mean, these are basically the momentum interpolated phase velocities for the east phase. One is without stars and one is with stars. That means we have the guess pressure and the guess velocities, and this is what we have. And we have another one which is basically supposed to satisfy both momentum and continuity. Okay, the discrete momentum and continuity equations. That means if you subtract one from the other, that means u e minus u e star will give you u e prime equals u hat e minus u hat e star would give you u hat e prime, plus you have d e times p p minus p p star will result in p p prime, p east minus p e star will result in p east prime. Okay, all right, so we essentially obtain an equation for the velocity corrections that we got here in the continuity equations, right, rho u e prime, from the momentum interpolated phase velocities. Okay, and what is this u e hat prime? This is basically nothing but your sigma n b n b prime plus b, right, divided by a p. Now of course this has to be neglected in simple, that is the approximation that is made in simple, right, because the neighboring velocities corrections are never considered. So that means the cell velocity corrections are always done by the pressure corrections alone. So this means we should take u e hat prime equal to 0. Okay, that means sigma n b u n b prime is basically taken to be 0 in simple algorithm as an approximation. Then what we have is you have the velocity correction on the phase, u e prime equals d little e times p p minus p east prime, right? That means u e prime equals d e times p p prime minus p east prime. Similarly we can write UW prime as DW times P west prime minus PP prime, and V north prime as D north times PP prime minus P north prime and V south prime as D south times P south prime minus PP prime. Okay, so these are the velocity corrections. Of course, correspondingly, you can write the corrections for the flow rates as Fe prime equals rho delta y UE prime, right? What we have here, rho delta y UE prime, but UE prime is now this quantity. So if you substitute that, what you get is rho delta y DE times PP prime minus PE prime. Similarly, FW prime would be rho DW delta y times P west prime minus PP prime. And F north prime is rho DN delta x times PP prime minus P north prime. And F south prime is rho ds delta x times p south prime minus pp prime. Okay, so remember, this is basically very similar to what we have done in the staggered grid algorithm as well, right? We have the prime flow rates, we have now related them to the pressure corrections. Now what do? We basically substitute for all these flow rates back into this equation one. That means on the left hand side you have everything in terms of pressure corrections, on the right hand side the star velocities are known. Okay, that means we have all of these ready, but only difference is between the staggered mesh and the right and the one we have right now is basically these DEs that we have are different, right? And the DEs are different, and also these P primes, these DEs come as a arithmetic average of D capital E and DP by 2 and so on, right? Whereas in the staggered grid they are already available because the U little E is already stored at the east face. Okay, so essentially we are doing the same thing but through interpolations, okay, not having a grid as such that is created, which will be helpful when we go for curvilinear meshes, because then we don't have to solve on any faces, but we kind of solve on the cell centroids and so on. Alright, so you essentially substitute for the Fe primes, then what you basically get is APPP prime equals sigma NBP NB prime plus B, where A east equals rho DE delta y, A west equals rho DW delta y, A north equals rho DN delta x, A south equals rho DS delta x, and in addition we have AP would be equal to basically, because there is a PP prime in every term, it will be equal to the same sum of all the coefficients sigma A and B, and the B term on the right hand side is basically minus Fe star plus Fw star minus F north star plus F south star. Okay, so this is the pressure correction equation. Once you solve this, you would get all the pressure corrections, then the pressure corrections can be used to correct the velocity corrections, to obtain the velocity corrections and the flow rate corrections, and these corrections can be added to the star values to obtain the correct values for phase velocities and phase flow rates. Okay, alright, so that is precisely the simple algorithm on collocated grid. So now let us kind of look at the overall algorithm, let us put all the things together, okay, then we will see how to basically what will be the final simple algorithm. Okay, so the simple algorithm on collocated grid, so we start off with guessing the velocities and pressures at the cell centroid. So this is basically guess the cell centroid values of velocities and pressures, right? So guess UP star, VP star, PP star, and in addition we need to also guess UE star, VN star. That means we have to guess velocities and pressures on the faces as well. Oh, sorry, only on the velocities on the faces, okay, because these are required in calculating the F stars, okay? So that means these are required. So these also need to be kind of guessed. Then you solve for momentum equations at the cell centroids, right? That is basically AP UP star. We have a U here to distinguish this guy from this guy, right? So that means AP U UP star equals sigma NB UNB star for U plus delta Y by 2. This is of course not correct. This cannot be PP. This should be PW, right? And this should be P south, right? We are talking about momentum equations where you still have the staggered pressures, or you still have the non-contiguous pressures which will support pressure checkerboarding. Okay, so this is PW star minus PE star plus BP, and the Y momentum equation is AP BP star equals sigma NB VNB star plus delta X by 2 times P south star minus P north star plus BP, right? I think these are the correct equations, right? We have it in somewhere before as well. Okay, All right, so essentially you solve to, essentially you converge these equations one after the other, right? And you obtain converged, basically converged UP, UP star or U star P and V star P values for the entire domain, right? Okay. Then essentially what you need to do is you need to now use momentum interpolation and calculate what is the star values. Okay. Okay, so that means calculate star values, that is basically UE star, UW star, VN star and VS star. Essentially you calculate from UE star equals U hat E star, right? U hat star E plus D times PP star minus P. So these are the guess values. And these are the arithmetic average values for the cells which are now converged, right? Use those and calculate what is the star values for the faces. Similarly, UW star equals U hat star W plus DW times P West star minus PP star, and V naught star equals V hat star N plus DN times PP star minus PN star, and V south star equals V south hat star plus D south times PS star minus PP star. Okay. Once you have all the phase velocities, which are the star phase velocities, calculate what is F E star, F W star, F N star, and F south star. That is basically calculate the flow rates and eventually calculate the B term. Okay. Then you have. Then you probably don't have to guess the values. Okay, so you probably don't have to guess the values for phases, isn't it? Okay, then you essentially, once you have this, then you solve for the pressure correction equation, that is APPP prime equals sigma NVP NB prime plus B. Okay, then once you have this, you correct the velocities. Okay, that means you correct UE as UE star plus UE prime, where UE prime is D little E times PP prime minus P east prime. V naught equals V naught star plus V naught prime, that is V naught star plus DN times PP prime minus P naught prime. So basically once you converge this, you know the pressure correction values. You of course also have to correct the flow rates. The flow rates are F little E, F little naught, all those things. That means Fe star plus Fe prime. So Fe star were calculated here, right? These were calculated here. Now, these have to be also corrected. That means Fe star plus rho UE prime delta Y, right? That is this guy multiplied by delta Y. And similarly, F naught would be F naught star plus F naught prime. That would be rho VN prime delta X. So correct the both the velocities as well as the flow rates. And of course, you have to also correct the pressures. Okay, that means correct the centroid pressure. That is PP equals PP star plus PP prime times alpha P. Okay, so you correct the. Now you still have to use under relaxation for pressure correction, because we are dropping the sigma NB, right? Or we are dropping UE hat prime, right? In the context of colligated mesh. Okay, then in order to improve convergence, let us also not only correct the phase velocities using this formula, okay? But also correct the cell centroid velocities, okay? So let us correct the cell centroid velocities as UP equals UP star plus UP prime, VP equals VP star plus UP prime. This is purely done to improve convergence, okay? It will kind of converge faster. So by analogy, we will use some UP prime as DP times, this is the staggered pressure corrections, okay? P west prime minus P east prime by 2, and VP prime equals DPV, these are capital P's, times P south prime minus P naught prime by 2, okay? So this is purely done to correct the convergence. If you don't do this, it will be a little slow, that's all, because we only have to correct the phase velocities and the pressures, okay? Then at this point, the phase velocities that we have corrected here satisfy continuity equation, right? The phase velocities that are corrected here now satisfy continuity equation. So that means you have a continuity satisfying field. So then you can solve for the additional scalar transport equations that you have in the domain. That is the equations for T, phi, and so on. So here use the flow rates, the corrected flow rates, that is F east, F west, F naught, F south, which are basically expressed in terms of U east, V naught, U west, V south, okay? Then once you do this thing, then you check for convergence. If you have not reached convergence, then you go back to step two. That means we go back to this step here, okay? Again, we solve for the momentum equations, but then now you have to take the updated up star as whatever is the up that is now corrected, okay? Up star equals up, vp star equals vp, pp star equals pp, and the velocities on the faces, that is ue star equals u little e, v naught star equals v little n, and of course the flow rates also have to be updated because they are also now corrected and they will be used later on. So fe star equals fe, f naught star equals f naught, and so on. Okay, so with this we go back and then essentially we come back to step 2 and then continue. Okay, fine. All right, so that is the simple algorithm on a collocated grid. It is pretty much similar to what we have on a staggered mesh. Only thing is that we are now solving on the collocated mesh and we have these hat velocities which should be helpful. And of course what you see is that essentially we are now working with two sets of velocities. One is the velocities at the cell centroids, the other one is the velocities at the faces, right? In the staggered grid approach we only had one set of velocity, that is the phase velocities always, right? Now we are trying to get away with the staggered grid method, so as a result we basically have two sets of velocities, okay? One is at up vp and the other set is u east, u west, v north, and v south. What you see is that basically these phase velocities are made to satisfy continuity equation, right? Because those are the ones which are going into the flow rates. Whereas this up, vp are not actually forced to satisfy continuity. As a result, we have two sets of velocities, one satisfies momentum, one satisfies continuity, and then we are kind of iterating. And as you reach convergence, both of them will come out to be of the similar values when you try to interpolate them, and they kind of satisfy both the equations as such. Okay, so that is the idea behind collocated grids, where we kind of use reach our interpolation and interpolate for the phase velocities and avoid pressure velocity checkerboarding that comes into play. Okay, so that is the overall algorithm. Okay, so I'm going to stop here. If you have any questions, do let me know through email, and I will reply to your queries. Okay, all right, thank you.